Hi, welcome to the world of Naadi Astrology, the techniques of Naadi. My name is Dr. N. Srinivasan Shastri. Actually, yesterday we had completed with the Jupiter, but because some people asked me for a Hindi version in between, I tried to manage. No, it was not that good. I was not satisfied with the message I was giving regarding this techniques. So I am just continuing it once more. And of course, I will also cover Sun in this. Okay. So it will be that two things, Jupiter and Sun. Fine. Everybody goes to an astrologer when they have got problems. First, when they go to an astrologer, they will take their charts, or at least they will have their date of birth. And nowadays we have so many softwares where we can draw a chart immediately. Okay, so when once you finish drawing the chart, maybe North Indian or the South Indian charts, you have to begin your prediction part of it, or you have to begin the study part of it. You have to tell the person who has come to you about, to know about him or to know about anything what he wants to learn from the planetary positions, right? So as soon as a person comes to the astrologer, first thing the astrologer should concentrate on Jupiter. I have been telling you all, in Naadi, we don't use Lagna and Dashabukti. Apart from that, where else we can find the details of a person and about his life or about his house, whatever it is? Through the techniques of Naadi, you can easily trace out so many things. This is what I am trying to give it today. Clear? So, Jupiter is the person. Whether this is a male chart or a female chart, Jupiter is the Atmakaraka, Jupiter is the person. Okay? So, when a person comes with a chart, first thing is we notice where the Jupiter is. In this case, it is Sagittarius. In this case, it is Sagittarius. So, according to the placement of Jupiter, kindly note this point. According to the placement of Jupiter and the planets which aspect Jupiter, or the planets in the trinal stars, trinal signs or Rasi from Jupiter. Clear? So three things we have to take into consideration while watching the Jupiter. Why we have to watch Jupiter is because Jupiter is the person in question. Jupiter is the native. It may be a male, it may be a female chart, but Jupiter is the native. So many people are under confusions that Venus will be a female chart important placement. No, it is Jupiter in common for both males and females. Okay, so when you try to look into this particular chart, of course you can analyze your own charts. But right now, I have got in front of me only two charts. Of course, same planetary positions in both the charts. When Jupiter in Dhanush or Sagittarius, the Rasi, Sagittarius or Dhanush, we first take the significations of the Rasi and put it for the Jupiter, the native. So what all the significations of Rasi? Its significations will be given to the native. The person will have that particular qualities. Point number one. And the person, the native, male or female, will get the qualities of the planets aspecting Jupiter. This is point number two. Point number three. He also carries the significations of the planets in the trinal houses. For example, Jupiter is a trinal for Aries and Leo. So even the planets in Leo could give the contributions of their significations, or planets which aspect, even that contributions is also got or given to the Jupiter. So the native, to know about the native, to know about the native's personality, we take the significations of the Rasi in which Jupiter is placed, the significations of the planets which is aspecting Jupiter, the significations of the planets which are in the trinal signs. And so many people were asking about conjunction of 4-5 planets. That comes in handy here. If at all there are 4 clear planets in the trinal signs, all the 4 planets will give the significations to that native if they are in the trinal sign to the Sagittarius or to the placement of Jupiter. Clear? So this is about Jupiter. This is how you can know about Jupiter. Okay? Now next, we shall go to the second house. Usually, from Lagna, the second house is called as Dhanasthanam, Vakasthanam, Kutamasthanam. Clear? Here also, from Jupiter, the second house is called as the Kutumbasthanam, Dhanasthanam, Vakusthanam. Okay? So, how do you know that he will have a very good financial position? Or to know about the second house, about the Kutumbasthan, Dhanasthan and Vakusthan? I will tell you this. For Kutumbasthan, he usually, we take Venus in case of a male chart. Dhanasthan, we take both the second house from Jupiter and also placement of Venus. I'll explain how it has to be utilized. Okay? Vakusthan, the second house from Jupiter will be completely the Vakusthan. Okay? One thing. I said Kutumbasthan first. Second house, if at all there is Saturn in the second house. This is an example, because what all I know, only that I'll put it and present. Okay? Of course, I'll take all the planets also. But important to where usually people get a catchy point is Saturn. When Saturn is placed in the second house from Jupiter, that is Makar or Capricorn. When Saturn is placed in the second house, because the second house acts like a Kutumbasthan, you can be very sure that the native is going to get a marriage according to his choice. Or he will hunt for the girl or boy, he or she will hunt for the girl or boy and then get married. Yeah. Here one more question may arise, whether he or she is going to get from the same caste creed. That depends upon the placement of Venus and Mars. In case of a male chart, you have to look into the placement of Venus and conjunction of Venus. That will give you a clear picture of how the wife will be. If at all Mars's conjunction gives you the placement and conjunction of Mars will give you the clear picture of the husband in case of a female chart. This is how we are going to take second house, the Kutumbasthan, into consideration. I will repeat once again. For Kutumbasthan, we have to know. If it is a male chart, we have to look into Venus. Dhanasthanam, Kutumbasthanam, Venus. If at all Venus is conjoined with Saturn or in the second house, from Jupiter, if Saturn is placed, you can be very assured that the girl or the boy, he is going to make his own choice. It will be a love marriage. Second point, you cannot even say it is a love marriage. There is one more option for it. You can clearly say that she or he will marry a known person. So it will occupy both the places. Even love, known person. Even a known relative, it is a known person. But whether he will belong to your caste or she will belong to your caste, your nationality, that you can know when the Mars or Venus, male, female or male chart. In case of a female chart, it is Mars. In case of a male chart, it is Venus. So if at all this Mars and Venus are in conjunction with Moon, definitely it will be a different national. If at all that Mars is in his own house, same caste but different subsect. Clear? See, there is a lot you have to observe here. It is not that easy. It is easy to look, but while explaining, if you can catch the point, then you are great. If it is a different national, Moon and the conjunction of Moon and Mars or Venus will be placed elsewhere. If that Moon, Mars are in Sun's place, if that Moon and Venus are in Sun's place, Sun, Leo, you can easily say it belongs, the girl or the boy belongs to the same blood, because Sun, same blood, but different subset. This is how we can know by planetary conjunction and planetary placement, whether the girl or boy is from the same caste or a different caste, or from the same nationality or a different nationality. Okay, this is about the Kutumbasthan, the girl or the family, better half. Now Dhanastharam is also there. Dhanastharam, if at all a malefic is there in the Dhanastharam, Sun, Saturn, Mars, definitely it will give more expenditure to the native. The money flow will be there according to the Venus, but because in the second house, when the Mars, Sun, Saturn, even Rahu and Kethu, they will spoil the second house, the income part of it, or Dhanasthanam part of it. Clear? Now next one, Vakusthanam. If at all you have Saturn, Mars or Sun, first we will take Saturn. If at all you have Saturn in the second house from Jupiter, that native, he or she, will be talking very roughly. If you got Mars, same thing, they will be talking very roughly. Clear? If at all Sun, though malefic, if he is situated in the second house from Jupiter, in any chart, male or female chart, those people will speak very practically, cut-right speech. Okay, this is about Vakasthanam. So Kutumbasthanam, Dhanasthanam, Vakasthanam, these three things I have to do it in this manner. You are going to follow the same if you find it interesting. So you can know the Kutumbasthanam means about the husband or the better half, and about the money, about the type of speech. Okay. If at all Mercury is there, in the second house from Jupiter, you can be assured money comes very fast. At the same time, money goes very fast. Mercury is the planet which gives anything spontaneously, abruptly, and also takes away spontaneously, abruptly. It may be expenditure, it may be reinvestment, whatever it may be, it will create a situation where the money will flow away fast. Clear? So this is about Mercury. And Venus, if Venus is there, these are the luckiest people. They will have a regular flow of money. So this is about the planets. Rahu and Ketu, I told you. Rahu, definitely. It will give trouble in the monetary affairs, even if it is there for Kutumbasthan. I mean, that is the second house from Jupiter. He will create trouble in the family marital life. Okay? If at all Ketu is there in the second house from Jupiter, these people may get into unnecessary arguments between the better halves, and the marriages, the marital life may bring them trouble. Okay? This is one angle of viewing the second house from Jupiter. Our Kutumba Vaku Dhanastan. Alright? Okay. Now how far? You can talk about the compatibility also here. Because finance, okay, it comes and goes. Or the flow is there. That nobody is bothered. But when we call it as family, that is Kutumbasthan, then we have to be more cautious to know how it's going to react, how the marriage will be, or the marital life will be. Okay? So in this context, now, most of the people are trying to tally it with nakshatras before getting married. The nakshatra of the boy and the nakshatra of the girl, it is tallied. Throughout ages, it has been tallied like that. I will ask you one question. You put it to yourselves. How many marriages, every parent, girl side or the boy side, every parent searches for a beautiful proposal for the son or the daughter. Okay. And they will take so much precautionary measures in picking up the boy or girl. By going to an astrologer and asking him about the compatibility, whether she will have children, whether she is going to live a happy life, whether he will have a happy life, whether he is going to live a, he is going to have children, whether the development will be there after the entry of the wife, or the development will be there after the girl gets married. Every parent will have all these thoughts in his head before getting his son or daughter married. They will go to number of astrologers also. There, they will also have lot of queries answered by the astrologer. And also, they tallied matchmaking. You got a lot of softwares nowadays. Particular bride star, particular bridegroom star, they tallied. Compatibility is 50 and above. Okay, fine. Then why so many marriages are going down the lane? Sometimes you see within 6 months there are a lot of troubles in the family. Sometimes within 3 months there will be a lot of troubles in the marital life. Why this happens? I've got a small reason. I'll tell you about that. I'm not saying our shastras or Vedic texts is wrong. No. But everybody is forgetting one beautiful thing, that is, if at all it is written in a chart that he is not going to have a peaceful marital life, that is the end. Rectification, that is secondary question. But when once it is written there, no matter you get a good girl for the boy, because of the boy's attitude, the girl may go bad. Okay, if you get a very good boy to a girl, because of the boy's attitude, girl to a boy, because of the boy's attitude, the girl may go bad. Vice versa. If you get a very good boy to a girl, the boy's attitude or the girl's attitude will spoil the marital life. Okay? How you can trace out that? Yes. Because I am doing about the second house, the techniques where you can know easily about the marital life, the happiness in the marital life is like this. For example, if you got And now this is a male chart. Let us assume this is a male chart. Venus is here. Clear? Jupiter is here. And nobody is there. Nobody is aspecting the Scorpio Rasi, Vrishchika Rasi. Nobody is aspecting. So the marriage will be okay. This is one point. Second, here there is one more angle where you have to have a look. The fourth house from Jupiter, Sukhasthanam. That is also your domestic house. That is also your family, husband, wife, kids, mother, father. All these are put together in one place. Fourth house. That's your family. If at all, in this context, it clearly says that there is no malefic in between. If at all there is a malefic in between Venus and Jupiter, in case of a male chart, happiness is there between the husband and wife. In case of a female chart, the same chart I will utilize for a female chart. Mars is the husband, Jupiter is the woman. So this is the wife and this is the husband. Before Mars comes here to meet the wife, he has to cross Rahu, he has to cross Sun, and then Saturn and Jupiter, both are there. So there will be problems. You cannot say this is a happy marital life. That's why we have to view the second house very carefully, taking Venus or Mars into consideration and the malefics in between the Mars and Venus, Venus and the Jupiter in case of a male chart, Mars and Jupiter in case of a female chart. If you take that into consideration, then only you'll be clear that this marriage will be happy one. Okay, about malefics. Then second, there is one more litigation here. So many couples go for a divorce. So many couples go for a court or something after marriage. Yeah. When the same Mars and Jupiter, if it has Mercury in between them, immediately after crossing. So as soon as Mars comes, that is after marriage. After that, if you find Mercury in the adjacent houses or anywhere nearby, according to that distance, you can tell how long that marriage is going to stick and after that, what's going to happen. It may not be necessarily court. It may be elders getting together and doing some sort of argumentation and getting back or trying to compromise the husband and wife. Even that situation is said by Mercury. If at all Kethu is there, definitely it will be roads apart. Okay, so this is what we can know about Mars and Venus. Please note it continuously. I am repeating this. In case of a male chart, it is Venus. In case of a female chart, it is Mars. The happiness is between the malefic planets, between the Mars and Jupiter. And don't ask me retrograde, it's going to turn back. It'll never turn back. It will be only for a certain period of retrogradeness. This is what I have noticed. Okay? And whether he is going to be of the same nationality, different nationality, same caste, different caste, that is through the moon and the placement of Mars or Venus and the placement of Venus. If Venus or Mars sits in their own houses, definitely the girl or the boy will belong to the same nationality. If it sits in moon's houses, definitely it will be a different nationality or different caste or different creed. Okay? And don't ask me. I have got a chart where Mars is there in Cancer, but he belongs to my caste only. Yes, other aspects are taken into consideration. So this is about Kutumbasthan, Vakusthan, Dhanasthan. When I said about Dhanasthan, I told you, Venus play a major role also. Kutumbasthan, I told you, how the happiness or Kutumbasthan will be cool. Now Dhanasthan. Dhanasthan, there is one more peculiarity. We get the Dhanasthan information from Venus. Because Venus is the one which gives us maximum information about the money. Here, a malefic placement will tell us that there will be more expenditure. But this expenditure part of it, on the other hand, if you notice Venus also, if Venus is placed in any chart, male or female chart, now Venus, I am taking it for money. Okay, if it is in Cancer, be very sure that money flows in and flows out very fast and abruptly. Clear? If Venus is there with Mercury, kindly note, in any Rasi or in any sign, Venus with Mercury, definitely that native, male or female, will have lot of inflow of income, too many sources of income. Clear? If it is placed with a malefic, expenditure will be more, unnecessary expenditure will be more. Watery places, this one. Dry places, Sagittarius. When Venus is placed in Sagittarius, it is a dry place. So the money flow will be there, but in a very less amount. If at all for anybody, if Venus sits in exaltation, Pisces, they will have a lot of vehicles, a lot of money and everything. And after marriage, if it is a male after marriage, the man, the native is going to develop a lot because Venus, the female, is in exaltation. Clear? If it is in exaltation for both male or female charts, they will have very good flow of money. They will see all the good things because Venus brings all the luxurious things. Venus gives us all the vehicles. Venus gives us a lot of money flow. Clear? And how you can see whether a man is going to grow rich or not? Okay? Right. The beautiful combination for a man to become rich, self-satisfied, heavy flow of money or lot of money in the house is when Jupiter in any Rasi or sign, okay? Jupiter in any Rasi or sign, if between the fourth house, if Venus is there in the fourth house, kindly note, I am repeating it. When Jupiter has Venus in the fourth house from Jupiter, in any sign, Jupiter placed in any sign, any Rasi, from Venus, from Jupiter, if Venus is placed in the fourth house, and in between the other three houses and or other two houses, if at all no malefic aspect, or if at all no malefic planets placement, if there is no malefic aspect between Jupiter and Venus, fourth house, only fourth house, I'm not talking about the fifth house, Jupiter in sixth house, Venus in fifth or sixth from Jupiter, Venus in fourth house from Jupiter and without any malefic planets aspect or placement in these signs, that man is going to make very good money. Don't mistake money for power. Power I'll come back again. That's not now. I want to take the second house only. I am concentrating on the second house. Of course, I will give you enough information about the planets, individual planets, what they are going to do, how a son will be getting along with the father or the mother or the wife. Wife I finished now. Wife or husband, if there are malefics, the marital life will be troublesome. Most of the times they may get along. I didn't say that they are going to go for a divorce, but difference of opinion will always linger on in that particular family where the if the combinations immaterial of Jupiter's placement wherever he is. Okay, so this is about second house. I think today I will complete up till the second house, Jupiter and Kudumbasthanam, Dhanasthanam, how you have to view it. Okay? About the money, when you come to money point, it is the second house. and Venus. When it comes to Kutumbasthanam, it is Venus in the male chart, Mars in the female chart. Whether it is your national or your same caste or subsect, you have to observe who is there in the second house. If Saturn is there, it is 100% sure that it may be long distant relative or a known person. Known person means known to the native, he or she, and it will be a love marriage. Okay? And the same Venus, there is one more important point. If the same Venus in case of a male chart is with Rahu, there are chances of that native eloping with that girl and get married elsewhere and coming back home. This I have seen, I have got a lot of examples with this also. And if the Mars is with Rahu, there are chances the girl going away with the boy, getting married somewhere else and coming back home. These are the possibilities. Kindly don't pinpoint me. These are the things what I have been noticing it. I'm just putting it in front of you all for your knowledge. If it is good after you telling with many horoscopes, if it comes good to you, you pick it. Otherwise, you can just forget. I want to share my knowledge. I'm not in any controversy. I don't want to have contradictory statements, or I don't want to give any. I don't be in any arguments. That is unnecessary. That is not worth for me. Clear? So second house part, I have finished. Because it says about money, because it says about the family, because it says about Vakasthana, I have told you what happens in the second house from Jupiter, immaterial of Jupiter placement, anywhere in any signs or rasis. Okay? Then I think today I'll end my session with this Jupiter in the second house only, because Jupiter is so beautifully placed in all, everywhere they, it will be beautifully placed, but planets after that only will give the main results. You wait for it until I finish the 12 houses, you will be almost a master in the subject. I promise on this. Of course, perceiving, how do you perceive it, that is left to you all. So till I meet you next time, I think I will bid. Bye.